Hi, my name is Nestor Moto Jr., and I am the secretary of Log Cabin LA.
And what does Log Cabin Republicans stand for that's different from what the general GOP platform is?
So Log Cabin is a gay Republican organization. So we pretty much bridge the gap between the LGBT community and the Republican community. And we are the middle of those two communities. And we pretty much just stand for freedom to marry, gay rights, and any other Republican position for the most part.
So there's a parade tomorrow. It used to be the LA Pride Parade. Now it's the Resist March. Is that right?
Yeah, there's a Resist March, I think, tomorrow.
What are they resisting?
Honestly, I don't know. I don't know what the Resist March is. I don't know what it does. I don't even know what it's supposed to do, because there's been a couple of special elections in the past couple months, and like they haven't won anything, and they're saying the resistance is strong, blah 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 blah. Like it's not, so I don't really know what it stands for.
Now you guys are the only ones wearing Make America Great Again caps. What kind of reaction do you get from the community?
It's been mixed, to say the least. We've had some good people. We had some supporters and things like that. But I mean, I've had people, there was a guy walking across, he was like, F you. There's the girl right now saying like, how can you support somebody that grabs women's vaginas and all that stuff? So I mean, you get everything, and it comes with the territory, and I'm pretty much already used to it, you know?
Is there a movement you think to try and overturn the election result?
I think liberals and the Democratic Party right now are wasting their time dwelling on November of last year. Like, Trump won already. We have to just get over it and they have to move on. And they still want to like continue with this whole Russia investigation and the Comey thing, which, to be honest with you, like this whole Comey testimony investigation has been a bunch of hogwash. It's a bunch of BS. Like, it doesn't do anything. It's not gonna change our minds. It's not gonna change anybody's mind. Like, and I think it's good though. It's good in a way for me, and it's good in a way for us, because the longer liberals and Democrats do this, like, the more elections we'll win. And the more we will see as Trump as a strong leader.
Do you think this Resist March is trying to polarize the community to march in step with what the drum that they're beating, and not differ from the party line, the leftist party line?
Oh yeah, like there is no difference right now between the liberal elite gays of the community. Like, they're just trying to brainwash everybody else, and it's kind of sad because like half of the people that are gonna go to the Resist March, maybe more, don't even know what it stands for. You know, they don't even know what it stands for. They're just doing it because everybody else is doing it, and it's sad because like these people are smart. These people should be able to take a position for themselves, and they should know that liberals and the Democratic Party stand for weak America. They stand for open borders. They stand for all that stuff, and it's not good. And it's not good for the country. And the longer they keep doing this, the more time Trump has to make sure that we move the country in the right direction.
Let's talk about the Pulse attack of last year, the Islamic attack. There was a massacre. What kind of recognition is there in this community of the Islamic mandated homophobia and violence towards homosexuals?
As from what I've seen and what we've seen, there's a lot of like Trump. There's a lot of gay. The gay community stands with Islam. The gay community stands with like our Muslim brothers and sisters. And I'm like, they don't understand that. Like, they don't understand like Islam, like radical Islam, kills us. You know, it kills us in Iraq and all in the Middle East. And I think like they have to see that because
and in the West.
Yeah.
And in Orlando.
Exactly. And I think like they have to wake up and see this, because we don't want any more of our community to be targeted. And this is why we're doing this, partially because we want to make sure that the victims of this attack don't go down as in vain. They don't go down as people that don't have a purpose. Because these people have a purpose, and it's to make sure that the LGBT community wakes up and sees radical Islam for what it is, and it's a monstrosity that needs to be absolutely abolished.
How good an awakening has there been in the year to this date?
Oh, there's been a lot more people that have come out in supporting us, and there have been a lot more organizations like the Pink Pistols and things like that. There was actually today there were like nationwide anti-Sharia marches across the country. Like,
there's no presence like that here at this parade, here at the fair.
There's a lot going on across the country right now. Again,
not in the homosexual community, LGBT community.
No. I'm pretty sure it probably means Hillary or Nancy or something. No, but this community is waking up slowly but surely. And I think we have a long way to go, not just for this community, to make sure that the world and the West sees that radical Islam needs to be exterminated. And I think Trump is doing a good job. I think Trump is doing a really good job with everything he said he was going to do.
It seems like this marches against him doing that. They're saying resist exclusion and this sort of thing regarding the travel ban.
It's this whole like Muslim ban, travel ban, blah, 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 blah. But people don't have to understand, like, we have to vet these people, you know? We have to vet them. And we have to make sure that we let the right people into the country. We can't just let anybody in. And that's what he's doing. And people need to understand that. And I think this, like I said, this resist march is nothing more than a pathetic attempt by the liberal elites to say, hey, I'm doing something. But they don't understand that they're losing elections left and right, and they're losing more and more political power as time goes on.
Within this community, do you think that they're marginalizing people who are not in step with the leftist agenda?
Yeah. I think like being gay is hard, but being a gay conservative is a lot harder. Being a gay Trump supporter is a lot harder. And
Christopher Street West, are they making it any easier?
And it sucks because this community says, oh, I stand for all this blah, 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 blah. And it's just a bunch of baloney. Like, but I also know, too, they haven't been challenged before. They haven't been challenged on their views, on what they believe in before. And so when they see that, they're like, oh, my God. And that's why we're here, to make sure that we have an opposing viewpoint.
Aside from your group, do you represent a measurable percentage of the population?
Do I?
No, I mean, are Republicans a measurable percentage of the LGBT community?
I think it's about maybe 1 in 3, maybe 1 in 3, maybe 1 in 4, and then some independents and Democrats. I think the gay community is a lot more open than people think. I think they just have to get off what they're reading, all that fake news stuff, because all that stuff is just brainwashing people. And I think at the end of the day, we as Trump supporters, as conservatives, whatever you want to call it, have to make sure we fight for every single community. We don't fight just for one. But that's what Trump did. That's what Trump did. That's what Trump is doing. And I think that's why we are on the right track right now. I think we have a lot more things to do and to accomplish. And I think Trump is doing that and will do that.